episode 1362, Does Busyness Affect Your Health?
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people. Happy, happy day. I pray that you are having a wonderful week. It is Wellness Wednesday, and you know what? It is time to look at your schedule. How are you packing it? Are you just stacking things on top of it? Does busyness affect your health? Let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, as time passes, these are the years when schedules are so full, there is barely enough time to breathe. Escaping from the busyness is hard to do. Does busyness affect your health? Always working and never resting? Vacation as an afterthought? Atta girl, atta boy only is heard for those burning the candle at both ends. So how's that working for you? How's it working for your health and your mental well-being? It probably is working just fine to the point of what you know now. From today through the end of the year, life is going to get even crazier. Think about it. Between the candy and the turkey, oh, sweet and savory, lovely. The costumes and the decorations, monsters and sparkly lights. You must take care of yourself. Otherwise, what will happen? You will end up sick and tired, unable to do what you really want to do this time of year. You see, this time of year is very, very special. I mean, think about it, moms, right? You enjoy going and getting those specific gifts for your sweet, special children, for your hubby. You love making the pumpkin pie and the homemade chocolate chip cookies. Okay, maybe not so much the turkey, but whatever you love, that's what you want to do. But if you're sick and tired in bed, if you're exhausted, not taking care of yourself, where will you end up between now and the end of the year? Possibly the hospital. We beat ourselves up until eventually our body says, stop. And our body has to put the brakes on. I know that for myself. I did it for many, many years. In fact, I can specifically remember between my freshman and sophomore year of college. I went home at the end of the year and I was going nonstop. I believe that semester I took either 20 or 21 hours. It was crazy. Okay, that was my second semester of my freshman year. As a freshman, I was taking that many hours. Yes, I know, crazy it was. And so I came off of 20 plus hours, whatever it was, 20 or 21 hours. And I went home, and at that time, home was Washington, D.C. Now, I had never actually physically lived there except as a baby, but we had since moved around. So we were back in a different location some 18, 19 years later. And there I found myself. Well, I already had committed to a few other things that I needed to do. One was I was hosting a class from Hawaii to come and be with us and visit the state capitol, and I was their chaperone. Oh, yes. I mean, there were other people, but I was their mainland chaperone. And it was awesome. I loved it. But it was long hours and lots of kids and just coming off of all of those 20 hours of taking classes. And then, oh, wait, I forgot to tell you. My mom and I drove back from school. I was in the heartland of U.S., so in the Kansas City location, and drove all the way. It was 23 hours and change. And it was a straight drive that it took us to drive from the Kansas City area into Washington, D.C. Crazy, yes, crazy, but we survived it. But you see, at the end of all of this, when I slowed down just enough, I got sick. I got so sick that I was taken to the emergency room by my parents. And they had to pump me with fluids because I was so dehydrated. I could keep nothing down. I was weak. I couldn't stand up. At that time, I was dating my husband, and he was so sweet. He would send me little letters because we wouldn't talk very much. Phone bills were very expensive. That was way before cell phones. And, you know, it was just one of those things where my body said, enough is enough. You cannot do any more. Does busyness affect your health? Oh, you better believe it. It does. So let's look at what you can do to not fall into the trap, or maybe see what you're doing now that could be creating an unhealthy lifestyle for yourself. Because you got to take care of you, right? So number one, what part of your body is most affected by your busyness? You may think your eyes, right? Because you've got to see things, you've got to do things. They may be tired if you don't get a lot of rest, but no, actually it's your adrenal glands. When you are working under stress and simmering in your busyness, your fight or flight is working overtime. You're always in high alert. You're standing at attention. This means that your adrenal glands are flooding your body with cortisol and epinephrine. It's just like a rush. It's a flood because you're in fight or flight mode. You're getting adrenaline fatigue the more and more you stay in this busyness, stressful environment. But the thing is we're raised that way now. If you're not completely booked, scheduled, and exhausted, you're not productive. Well, honestly, the last part is the truest part of that whole phrase. You're not productive. We think we are because we're doing all these things. But in all of these doing things, are we really impacting the world that we're supposed to be touching, that God wants us to touch? Number two, if you're under stress, you're really busy, what area that you need to survive, you've got to have in order to survive, can become damaged? Now, this is your body. And no, it's not your heart. It deals with blood. Yes, it's blood vessels. Chronic stress may raise your risk for heart attacks and strokes by increasing plaque buildup that clogs your arteries. You can also have high blood pressure. And on top of that, the more you overuse your senses, they will dull over time. And if you're looking to lose weight, busyness is not for you. High cortisol keeps your body hanging on to fat. It's a magnet. Bring on the fat. So yeah, if you're wanting to lose weight and you're thinking, gosh, I don't know, maybe it's just my age. Maybe not. Maybe look at your schedule first. Maybe you're stumbling there and you're just not thinking about it. If you're always in fight or flight mode, that cortisol, oh, it's working and it's good that we have it there. But God did not prepare our bodies and design our bodies to be in fight or flight mode 120% of our life. That's craziness, totally craziness. Number three, you have no time for exercise, but lots of time for more work and activities. Yep, you're good at stuffing, but you're not good at stopping. What are you subjecting yourself to? Higher risk of cancer and heart disease. October, Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Think about it. Do you really want to increase your chances of getting cancer or heart disease? Yeah, no. Exercise is one of the best ways to prevent disease. If you're sitting all day with little to no intentional movement, you're increasing your chances of heart disease, cancer, or a multitude of other diseases. You've got to take care of your body. You've got to move more. And so make time for that exercise, even if it's a brisk walk. You've got to take time for you. Number four, will you get more sick with constant busyness and stress? Yes, yes, and yes. Burning your candle at both ends keeps you in a tired fog, wearing you down and weakening your immune system. With a weakened immune system, your body is not ready for battle. So when you get sick, right, it's like, I don't feel like fighting. That's what happened to me. I kept giving and giving, long hours at school, coming right off, and then being with my Hawaii classmates, and they weren't really classmates, it was the class that was there, and just experiencing it with them and just going on to the next thing. And before you knew it, I was just like, that was it. I could not do anymore. My body said, no, you're done. And that's what it did. My body couldn't fight. It was giving up. So you have to be very, very careful. Are you going to get more sick? Can you be more susceptible to other things? Yes, you can. Number five, it's time for a potty break. Okay, not really. Don't hang up yet. We're still talking here. How does busyness affect your stools? Now, I'm not going to get all descriptive here on you because you might be eating or having a snack, and that's wonderful. But we've got to talk about being in the bathroom. We do. Did you know busyness can actually give you diarrhea or constipation, stress? That constant, always on the go. When you are constantly on the go, putting fires out and being everything to everybody, your digestive system will respond. And it's going to respond either through your bowels by them moving more quickly, or they won't be going as consistently as before. So you're going to have what? Diarrhea or constipation. Either way, it's not fun, is it? Further, your body can have a challenging time accepting nutrients you're feeding it. So if you're noticing like, gosh, I'm just not like feeling, you know, energized enough. And it's not because of sleep, because you feel like basically you're getting within 1.5 hours of what you normally do. And maybe it's, yeah, everything else seems normal, but what's off, even your diet's on, but what's off is that your bowels aren't moving properly and you're eating well, but you just kind of feel like you're not getting what you need. This could be part of it. Your digestive system is very, very important. So you got to pay attention to that. What are your stools doing? What are they showing you? It tells a lot. Even though we don't want to talk about it, I get it. Number 6, got headaches? When you are so busy, where do your headaches come from? Well, believe it or not, headaches can stem from tense muscles. And it's the stress that comes with the busyness that tenses up our muscles, right? And that causes our body to react. It triggers our body. Sometimes that means we'll have a stiff neck, tight shoulders, a tight jaw even, and then what? Migraines or headache. We get that because our body's like, oh my gosh, I'm supposed to be on point here. I'm supposed to be doing all of this and I'm really kind of tired, but wait. She's telling me I've got to keep going. And the brain keeps sending the signal saying, come on, stimulate more. And you're overworking yourself. And that brings up tense muscles, which triggers all of these other things that happen within our body, including headaches. So maybe you're not one who has headaches typically, but you're noticing that, man, that you just get a little pounding in your head or something's hurting. You can't put your finger on it. I'm very blessed. I do not get headaches very, very rarely. My husband, not so much blessed. He grew up with migraines. In fact, when I started dating him, he had horrific migraines. He was one that he would have to be in a dark room. It had to be cool, quiet, no talking. And it would just hurt him. It hurt him to move everything. And it was debilitating for him. It has gotten better now over time. Now, I would like to think it's me. I don't know that it is. I believe it's God and him working out ways for his body to react and how he handles stress and what he puts on himself. But your body reacts to things. You've got to pay attention to your body. Does busyness affect your health? By golly, it does. Number 7, this is for you specifically, women. You got to listen up to this one. When you work too much, how much will you increase your risk of cancer, heart disease, diabetes, and more? You're going to triple your risk. Triple it. You are 3 times more likely to get diabetes, heart disease, cancer, and all when you're working 60 or more hours, the majority of your schedule in a week. And that means, yes, both at work and at home and at church and at school, wherever you are working constantly, all of those hours add up, not just what's on your paycheck card. So women have a higher risk, right? Because it's a combination of everything. All of these responsibilities that we have. We have to have broader shoulders to carry the weight load. But that also means you have to be more in tune to your body. It's so important. So pay attention to what your body is saying. Busyness does affect your health. Number 8, can stress hinder you from having children? Now, you might be saying, I'm done having children, so this doesn't apply to me. No, but you may have a daughter. You may have a niece. You may have a girlfriend who has a daughter. Listen to this. Stress does hinder you from having children. It can affect you because the stress hormones mess with your reproductive system. It also messes up with men. So let's talk about the men first. It can curb their sperm production along with lowering testosterone levels. That's not good, right? If you're a couple that's, you know, both of you are under high amount of stress, maybe you're both going to graduate school, maybe you both are, you know, doing things in your career that are requiring you to go above and beyond what you normally do in your normal life, this can have an effect on you being able to conceive. Now, women, for you, you can have irregular cycles. And you definitely will have less sexual desire when your bodies are just swamped with stress. You just don't want anything to do with it. You're just too tired. You're too stressed. You're too busy. And even scheduling it is not going to work. So you've got to look at how your calendar is affecting you for having children. Now, if you're the mom who has a daughter, think about this. As they get older and they go from high school into college and college into the real world, this may come up in discussion with you at some point. And you'll be maybe like, wait, I remember this. I remember hearing something about it. We've got to pay attention to how we are piling on stuff to do. And yes, we may have moments or days, or it may be a week at a time, but when this is 365, 24/7, that's the problem. And when you're only taking the 365, 24/7, and of that time, you may get a week and a blink of that for rest time. Big question marks here, big red flags. God cannot work through you when you are physically, earthly exhausted. You have got to be heavenly ready by being not as stressed here on earth. Think about it. I know it's not something that we talk about. It's not something that we pull up a chair and let's gather around a table, girlfriends, and we're going to talk about our schedules and how it involves our stress. Is busyness really working for you? I don't know. Is it? I know for me, when we were going through a very challenging time in our marriage, and my husband said, I've fallen out of love, and all chaos broke out. That sent me into this mode of, I've got to look at every aspect of my life. And when I say every aspect, I'm talking about, you know, when you think about a linen closet that you need to clean out because you just got stuff crammed in there. Oh no, I was talking about every nook and cranny in my life, from where I volunteered to when I woke up to when I went to bed to when I fed the kids to how I dressed them to when I did laundry to when I vacuumed. I looked at every nuance in my life. Been there, done that, and sometimes I do it now. I don't have to do it so much under a fine-tooth comb because I've already gone through it. And so now I'm more aware and I can change things quicker and I can see it usually and catch it before it actually happens. I've been through it. Stress has a huge effect on you. But what do? We keep doing the same old thing. And how's that same old thing working for you? Probably not real well. Now, if you woke up this morning and you're bouncing out of bed, praise the Lord, that's awesome. I pray that's how it happens every single day. And if you may have one or two days off, that's okay. Meaning you just have an off day, right? It's just, it's an okay day. You're going to have those days. That's all right. But this is when you start seeing a pattern that you're living day to day to day. And this is how it's looking in your life and how you're feeling. And then what does your work performance look like? You've got to be able to say enough is enough. So what can you do to improve your health performance and your mood? What can you do to change your attitude? You got to take breaks. You need vacations and you need rest. Stop stuffing your schedule to the point of no room for breathing. If you are literally running from one thing to the next, this is your wake-up call. Wake up. Make time for meditation and rest. Use your vacation, even if it's a staycation. I get it. Sometimes you don't always have money to go somewhere. That's okay. Take a Monday or a Friday off and give yourself a three-day weekend. Bonus. It's amazing what that can do for your health and well-being, your mental stability. It's important. Give yourself breaks throughout your day. Schedule them in. Schedule your fitness. Schedule your breaks. Allow yourself what? Creative flexibility. When I'm doing interviews, very, very rarely will I do more than two interviews on one single day. And honestly, I try to only do one a day. Why? Because the amount of energy that I have to put in, not just to know the book, but to understand the author and her story or his story and what their book is about and what they want to, you know, have come out of the conversation. It takes a lot of preparation, a lot of energy when I'm speaking with them that by the time I'm done, I feel zapped. And so it's important for me to have kind of padding on either side, guardrails, so to speak. You need guardrails in your life. You need to be able to take breaks. You need vacations. You need rest. What guardrails do you have in your life today? Not only will this help you with your performance, but you will be healthier and happier. And ultimately, God wants us to live a joyous life. He doesn't want us upset. He wants us to be the best person we can be. But we can't do that when we're so busy. What does your schedule look like from now to December? You got to take your life seriously. Life deserves to be well lived. Are you living it well? Are you just living it because, well, it's responsibilities. It's, I signed up for this. It's, we did to do, you know, we decided to do this as a family. Well, I don't know. I couldn't say no, so I said yes. Yes is my favorite word. No, not so much. Okay, wake up. Enough is enough. Maybe you don't know how to pare down your schedule. Maybe you're like, you have three kids and you're like, I don't know if I can take anything away from them. Maybe you have your husband who travels and you're like, wait, but I've got my business too. And when I look at it, all I see is a pile of stuff and I don't know where to begin because when I go in that pile, it's just easier for me to do the same thing that I know how and I just keep living that same life. I get it. I did it. But I also changed it and it changed my life. If you want help with that, click on the link, take aim in the show notes. I have a free gift for you. It's a coaching call with me. Maybe you've never experienced coaching. That can be kind of a scary thing when, you know, coaching is something newer. It's been around for a long time, but with it actually coming out to the general public, you'll have people who are coached in your exec offices. You'll have people who are coached, they're entrepreneurs, and you'll have these areas that are like, oh yes, they know about the term coaching. But when you come into the public sector, it's like, well, no, maybe I have. I've heard of counseling, but coaching, I'm not sure. They both start with C. Where do I begin? Coaching is simply a conversation. You have a dialogue. But the cool thing is that you have someone who is not emotionally invested in the situation that you are sitting in right now. Which means, yes, they care about you as a person, but the outcome to it or what's happening, they can see above and beyond it. They can ask questions that allow you to dive deeper, to see things from a different perspective, a heavenly perspective. And being able to compare it to the earthly perspective or pulling it from somebody else's perspective. It's very important to be able to do this. And no, it's not something that comes very easy for a lot of people. So if you're saying, I just need some help, I don't know what to do, but I do know that I'm drowning. That's what I know. Then click on that link, take aim in the show notes. Take a chance on you. Stop drowning today. When you click on that link, a little form will pop up. Fill out that form and it comes right to me. I will send you back an email and we will get you scheduled for a coaching call. I promise you, it will be well worth your time. It's a gift from me to you. Does busyness affect your health? Well, I'm sure by now you know that answer. Of course it does. And as much as we would like to pretend that it doesn't, it really does have an effect on us. And we've got to kind of put on our big girl panties, and we've got to stand up, and we've got to use the word no. Enough is enough. Drop the excuses. Stop comparing. You don't have to be Susie Q and Mary. You need to be you, present and incredible. You don't need to try to be who your mom was, or at least how you thought she was when you were growing up. That's all comparison. God designed you, created you on purpose for a purpose. You need to be living out that. And sometimes we clutter our lives, yes, with activities, yes, with too many yeses in our lives, and not with enough no's. We've got to be able to pare down to what we need in our lives so we can see the blessings that God has before us. Take your life seriously. Life deserves to be well lived. Take care of the body God has given you. If you're not sure where to start, ask yourself this question: what can I give up today to give back more tomorrow? Go out, live, love, and impact. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.